Guys, the last few months have been really interesting for us PC enthusiasts. New graphics cards have been announced and released, and people who now want to build a high-end gaming PC have great new options available. However, those of us who want to build a mid-range gaming PC without paying $500 for a GPU still have problems to find graphics cards with a great price-performance ratio. This has not only been true in 2019, but especially in 2020, where the recent pandemic increased the prices of almost every hardware part. And while many graphics cards are selling for $100 to $200 over their MSRP nowadays, others have been completely out of stock and are pretty much unavailable, which is devastating for PC enthusiasts wanting to build a decent gaming rig. One mid-range graphics card that is still available and selling for its MSRP of about $240 though is the Nvidia GTX 1660 Super. The complete GeForce 16 series is based on the Turing microarchitecture and was announced in February 2019. And so the 16 series was commercialized within the same time frame as the 20 series, and it was created specifically to address the entry and mid-range market. And even though the GTX 1660 did not support ray tracing at first, Nvidia updated their drivers in April 2019, enabling DirectX ray tracing on it. And that makes this GPU one of the cheapest that support probably the most anticipated feature Nvidia ever released. With 1408 CUDA cores, a boost clock of 1785 MHz out of the box, and 6GB of GDDR6 memory, we are getting a nice graphics card that is not only suited for esports titles, but also for AAA titles. That is because while the 6GB of GDDR6 combined with a bandwidth of over 300GB per second provide a solid foundation for WQHD or 4K rendering, the high clock frequency also ensures high frame rates in FPS titles. And that might make the 1660 Super just the best option for those looking to build a new mid-range gaming PC capable of esports titles as well as AAA titles. I've got the Gigabyte GTX 1660 Super Gaming OC version here, which I'm really impressed with. I especially like this one because it's almost silent and the temperatures are very low even under full load. But the dual fan versions are almost as good as this one while being a few bucks cheaper, and so they are definitely also competitive options. However, this card barely touched 60 degrees in the stress test, which in my mind is just insane given how much FPS I got in the game tests. The GTX 1660 Super requires an 8-pin power connector, as its power draw is rated at 125 watts maximum. On the back, this model has 3 DisplayPorts 1.4 and 1 HDMI port 2.0, which is enough to support 3 4K monitors or 4 1080p monitors. But now, let's take the GTX 1660 Super through a few titles and see how it does. The test system also features a Ryzen 9 3900X on an X570 motherboard and 32GB of 3600MHz RAM. If you want to see game benchmarks of other hardware parts, be sure to hit that subscribe button as that will come out in the next few months. Now, I did test this particular card at different resolutions and different graphic settings depending on how the card performed at the specific titles. And for each game I tested, I also recorded current FPS, average FPS, bottom 1% FPS, CPU load, GPU load, and RAM usage. But now, enjoy the game tests. Oh, we're still here, flipping coins about what's to come. It starts getting cold, and we don't know any way that he would try to understand how it all started to go wrong. But the sea is way too deep, yeah, it's deeper than we could ever go, honey. We have to be together here in the storm.
We should be proud. face is filled with sadness. When words are said, we'll regret. I can see the fire that we made just to save us when we try to make up for never letting go. Said the things we promised not to say, that we break up just to start all over, even though we know this is the hard way better. We can't be heartache together. This is the hard way better. We can't be heartache.
So these were all the game tests. I think that the results I got are really impressive. I could play many esports titles at 4K and max settings at high FPS, and was also able to get smooth frame rates in all AAA games I tested, especially at 1080p and WQHD. And so with the GTX 1660 Super, I think you can pretty much enjoy all the games that are currently available. Overall, I think the GTX 1660 Super from Nvidia is one of the best mid-range gaming graphics cards you can currently buy. With the Nvidia 20 series still being priced relatively high, this GPU is a great alternative for any mid-range gaming PC. And so to answer the question of the title, I think in late 2020 the GTX 1660 Super is definitely a worthy graphics card. I would be very happy to put this in my mid-range build myself, but of course I want to hear what you guys think in the comment section below. As always guys, a huge thanks for watching, don't forget to hit that like button if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one.